The greatest cause of conflict in marriage is finances. And Jesus said something in the book of Matthew, pastor, you can get me that verse or after it. Jesus said that you cannot serve two masters, and I want it in NIV. You cannot serve God and serve mammons. Then in the book of 1 Timothy, in Asema, the love of money is the root cause of all evil. Money is not evil, but the love of money is what is evil. We need money to be able to survive and meet our needs when we are here on earth. If you love money in the expense of your children, if you love money more than yourself, then that's where now the mistake comes in. And so the purpose of, we must get it right, just like the way we learned in secondary school, that money is a medium of exchange. Let it remain at that level. So when you have money, the reason why God gives us money is so that we can, I can use it. We can use it with my wife. I can use it myself as a medium of exchange. So money should never give you value. You are the one who gives money value, because you should master money. Money should not master you. If you get that, the one who gives that car a class by driving it. Otherwise, if you have a showroom, it has no value. The people, the manufacturers, are praying for customers to come and carry it and give it value. So if that thing gets out of your mind, you'll be okay. This dress I'm putting on, whether I bought it 5,000, 10,000, a dress, there's nothing you should ever put and feel that you look classic, you look presentable, yeah, you are expensive, you know? No! It is, you are the one who gives value to any dress. Because as long as it's on the shops, it has no value. So if that reverse thinking can get into us, we are sorted with money madness. And I want to tell you that this is something and a serious sickness that has remained for generations. It's the root cause of all evils. Why? If you realize that, the heart is there. It's somewhere I've seen faith. Because faith is an issue of your heart. So money wants to replace the faith you have in God. It wants to take the same dominancy. Why is that so? Because the God of this world, who is Satan, is the one who controls the world race system. And that's why when Jesus was being tempted in the book of Matthew 4:4, Satan told him, if you worship me, I will give you all the riches of this world. Because initially, all these riches belonged to man in the book of Genesis. But after man sinned, the devil took over. For God led Jesus into the wilderness. So physically, Jesus was in the wilderness. Are you getting that? When he's in the wilderness, the first temptation was true. It was physical. Where he was, because in the wilderness we find stones, we find sand. Is that not true? So he was telling him, turn these stones to become bread. Jesus answered, it is written. But the second temptation and the third temptation was a temptation of the soul. And that's why verse 5 explains that. Then the devil taketh Jesus into a holy mountain. What does that mean? And showed him all the kingdoms of the world. And all these things I'll give unto thee, if thou shalt fall and worship me. Then says Jesus unto him, get away, Satan, for it is written, thou shalt worship the Lord thy God. And only him shall you serve. So what are we talking about? Money has a way of getting into your heart. But when your spirit is the king, you become a master. You are not mastered by money. And that's why most of the people, anytime they get a child and money comes in, they marry a second wife, marry the third wife, marry the fourth wife, because money has taken over their heart. Even if you ask them, they also don't know. But this is what happens. So for you, when you're handling finances, handle them effectively. I remember one time pastor wanted to buy a car. And me, for sure, there was no need for a car in that home. It is not a million shillings. So me, I'm wondering, natokanga nyumbani, nakuja kazini miguu, juu it is just like 3 minutes. In my mind as a woman, ata misi tumiangi gari. Naona magari, what is it for? But I could tell, this thing is not from the mind. Imeingia kwa heart. Nikaangalia, nikaona pana, do the circumstances allow, yes. With it, destroy my children's school fees? No. I allowed him to buy it. Kumbe amekuwa akitaka to drive these big cars. You're getting, you know, men want big cars, big things. And do you know what? I keep asking myself, suppose nilimuletea shida. So what you do, you weigh. Hii kitu mzee anaongea, inatoka kwa akili au iko kwa moyo. And every time you pass, anambia, you know what, my wife, I'm driving this car. Watoto wanasema, anambia baba, baba, gari yako ndio hiyo imepita. Baba ndio. And so, it reached that point and he must buy. But in me, as a wife, nikuwa naona sasa gari. Si fatari hata tuminue plot after 10, after 3 years, inaesa kuwa 10 million or 5 million or 3 million. Me. Kati nikaangalia pastor. Nikaona hii finances. You see, what am I doing? Bypass. If that will bring peace in my family and it is not distorting our finances, see, I'm moving. Are you getting the point? And we only had an excitement only for 3 months. After that, it is no longer now an excitement. Let me tell you the truth. There is nothing you will have in this world that you feel umefika. Before you marry, unasemanga, mani kipata watoto, pata watoto uone. Ambio na wale tuko na watoto. Unakuta watoto wakupatini. Unasema ile wakati mani tanunua gari ya kwanza. Si nitasikia nimeachimu. Unanunua. Unakuta it is a liability. Unasema hiyo siku mani tanunua plot nione kwa ati nikuwe na kanyumba kangu. Hata kama ni 2 bedroom. Unajenga nyumba ya 10 bedroom. Unakuta haujatosheka. Are you getting the point? There is always something we call destination sickness. And it has made people to have toxic and violent and abusive marriages because of thinking the other place has greener pasture, and it is not. The first responsibility is to our family first, the immediate family, me, my husband, the children, to make sure the school fees is paid, if we are renting, rent is paid, if water bills and electricity is paid. After that, the next people who usually use a lot of money in a family is your immediate family members. That could be your mother, your father, both sides, your sisters, and your brothers, or a cousin or an uncle. If you want to survive money and make sure that you're not exploited by relatives, and when you talk about relatives, we are talking about your mother, we are talking about your father, learn to swap. And this has helped us, and we have helped so many couples with that truth. So what do you do? Kama ni pastor munene to meet the needs of the family, na mama yake anataka kusaidiwa na pesa, na tuseme alikuwa amemwambia, nilikuwa nataka, niko na chama, na nilikuwa nataka kumuuliza, kama unaweza nipatia 50,000 by December, nitashukuru. Ni mama alimeplace order. If we want to help the mother, if Munene keeps helping the mother, he will never stop. Because kuna vile wamekuwa wakiperekana kutoka anze kupata pesa akiwa kijana. Lakini kumbuka, kuna mtu mwingine amekuja hii old wife. So since, if you don't know how to break this, what happens? You are relative, your father, your mother, your sisters, you wanajua kuko generous, wanajua kikuitisha kitu kataangi, that you can easily be manipulated, you can easily be misused, because kujui utawambia nini, na uliwazoesha wapatia pesa. This is what we advise couples, learn to swap. Mama ameitisha 50,000, that is the policy of Pastor Munene. We always cut that money by half. We are not the only children in that home. Hakuzaa sisi tu. Are you getting the point? My mother has 9 children. And there is nobody that is not working. So what an isitifanya, I'm the Jesus of my mother. And I'm the Jesus of my father to be providing their needs. So for us, every parent, when a parent presses 100,000 need, we always cut it by half. So this is what we do. Even if the M-Pesa is in Pastor Munene, he puts the money in my phone, then I send money to the mother. Na tu kuongea na yeye, waliongea na the son. And this has brought a lot of healing in our marriages. My mother alikuwa ameniomba pesa na tukaongea na yeye because she feels free to talk with me. But when Pastor Munene sends money to my mother, there is something we are telling her. In this family, we do not have secrets about money, even without talking. The greatest mistake that husbands do without knowing is refusing to show their wife payslip. Why? We get an imaginary amount of what you get. For example, let's say Munene is employed and he gets 120, and we have the school fees of 60,000 for the four children, and we have a house we are paying 20K. And so how much is that already used?
80.
Yeah, 80. So what is the balance? 40. And we need food in this house. We need to help my mother-in-law. We need to help mother, father-in-law. It will be very clear to me. Even you find I have not been passed by. But if he keeps driving the car he drives, I don't know how much. I'll keep on thinking there's a lot of money he has. Now, the person at hand kunyonyesha pay slip, juanajua hii pesa nikiona nitastuka. I'm giving you the reasoning of a woman emotionally. And that is what has, it is a myth. It is a myth that has remained with so many people. Women don't know what to do. So they keep building castles, and that can bring a problem in your finances. Even when you have done the best, a woman still feels you have not done the best. Because according to your pay slip, you have 300,000. If you are married to a real wife, yule wa mama wanaitwa kutumia wamburi, hakuna mtu angetaka kupush the husband beyond what he earns. If you are married to a true wife, unless it's a concubine anaweza kukupush. But a true wife, the more you expose the truth to a woman, the more real she becomes. The more you hide the truth from her, the more she views those black spaces. And so it is for your good. Even you can question her. How do you tell me to buy you a dress of 15,000? And you know what we are earning? Are we realistic? And don't say, are you realistic? Are we always using we? Are we really realistic? Because kuna school fees inakuja 60,000. Kuna rent ambayo lazima tulipe. Na hizi bili zingine na stima ngi zingine tano. Hii ni gari niko nayo. It has an insurance. So at the end of the day when you make her even work more hard. And that's what I tell men. If your wife is not working, empower her with this little money. Make sure that she begins a small business. Hata kama ni ya kuuza nguo za watoto za mtumba, let your wife also contribute positively to kuinua the family's income. Your husband will take the same money, invest it as an asset. And probably write the name of your son or your daughter. Are you getting that? Because you may find, you know your wife. You know your wife, you know your husband. So there are times you feel, if he brought nikiandika na mzee, anaweza shikwa na wazimu, akunywe na toroki aende Tanzania. Instead of that, we have children here to give him security. Why don't I write it with wisdom? Ya mama nene. Because there's something I can see and I don't want to hurt him. So weigh the situation. Because when it is in an asset, though I have bought it at 200,000, in the next 5 years or 10 years, it might help this boy when he's in the university. Because a man must be long-term in vision. So you can turn that money into asset, but let your wife know, kuna kitu kama hiyo. Na si yake ni ya watoto. Do you have known your wife is extravagant? Anaweza hata yeye chukua hiyo product iandika na yeye na auze. Anyone can get all this money madness we are talking about. And all this is because people don't know how to handle money. Adam was the provider. There was peace. Mungu alikuwa anatembea, anawazungumzia afternoon na jioni na anarudi kwa kama anarudiana. Lakini ile siku Eve alifikiria hata mimi naweza provide for this family. Kwani ni yeye tu akaprovide. That's when sin and death and all this confusion we have was brought by provision. What am I saying? This is what I told myself when I knew that. That's why the word of God is very important. I keep saying this, Susan, even if I earn 2 million in a month and Pastor Munene comes with 100,000, I cannot give Munene. I can only support him. Because even naturally, the way I am, I'm not a giver, I'm a receiver. And so every woman must clear your mind that anytime I find myself providing, I am now not a husband. I'm a supporter of what my husband, what we have agreed as a family.